Now, let us see what is a keyword, what are the various keywords available in C language. Before giving the definition of a keyword, let me ask some questions to you. Can you tell me what is this? This is letter T. This is N. This is I. If we treat this as one word, there is no meaning associated with this word. But if these letters are combined together like this, we get a word int. We don't know what is the meaning of this word, so we cannot identify this word. But the compiler can identify what this word is. This word has a standard and predefined meaning in C language. So I write this word has a standard and predefined meaning in C language. Hence, we call such words as keywords. Any word such as this that can be understood by the compiler, we call it as keyword. Various keywords available in C language are shown below. Auto, double, int, struct, break, else, long, switch, case, enum, register, typedef, char, extern, return, union, const, float, short, unsigned, continue, for, signed, void, default, go to, size of, volatile, do, if, static, and while. If you observe, totally there are 32 keywords. All these keywords shown here are reserved for specific purpose in C language, and hence these keywords are also called reserved words. Now we can give the definition of a keyword. A sequence of letters called words shown here. Keywords shown here that have standard and predefined meaning in C language are called keywords. Since the keywords are reserved for specific purpose in C language, they are also called reserved words. Various keywords in C language are shown below. These are all the keywords available in C language. The meaning of each keyword and the explanation of each keyword is given in the coming sections. Now, let us see some of the points that we have to remember when we use keywords. Point number one, the compiler knows the meaning of all keywords. For example, if I write int, the compiler knows that we are manipulating integer data. If we write float, the compiler knows that we are manipulating floating point data. So we say the compiler knows the meaning of all keywords. Point number two, the meaning of keywords cannot be changed by the programmer. For example, if we write int, the compiler knows that we are manipulating integer data. We cannot tell the compiler to manipulate floating point data. So, we should remember that the meaning of keywords cannot be changed by the programmer. Point number three, the keywords should be used only for their intended use. For example, if we write int, we are supposed to manipulate only integer data and not floating point number such as 99.6. Suppose we write float. If we write float, it means that we are supposed to manipulate only floating point numbers such as 99.6, 3.14 and so on. Using this float, we should not manipulate integer numbers. So, the keywords should be used only for their intended use. In short, point number one is, the compiler knows the meaning of all keywords. Point number two, the meaning of keywords cannot be changed by the programmer. Point number three, the keywords should be used only for their intended use. Now, let us see what are the rules to be followed while using keywords. First one, all keywords should be written only in lowercase letters. See here, all these keywords are written in lowercase letters only. If we change any of these characters to uppercase letters, they become identifiers. For example, if I change any of these letters to capital letters, it will not be a keyword. Instead, it becomes an identifier. If we change any of these lowercase letters to uppercase letters, it will not be a keyword. Instead, it becomes an identifier. What is an identifier? That we see in the next section. The second rule is, the keywords should not be used as identifiers to identify program elements such as variable names, array names, and so on. That is, keywords should not be used as variable names. Keywords should not be used as function names. What is a variable? What is a function, etc., are discussed in the next classes. Now, let us see what is the outcome of this video. Point number one, we know the definition of a keyword. We can say a sequence of letters that have standard and predefined meaning in C language are called keywords. Since the keywords are reserved for specific purpose in C language, they are also called reserved words. Now we go to point number two. We know the various keywords available in C language. These are all the keywords available in C language. Totally 32 keywords are available in C language. Point number three, we know the rules to be followed while using keywords. First rule is, all keywords should be written in lowercase letters. Second rule is, the keywords should not be used as identifiers. In short, we say, what is the outcome of this video? Point number one, we know the definition of a keyword. Point number two, we know various keywords available in C language. Point number three, we know what are the rules to be followed while using keywords.